time.
Jersey, let's go. Redskins future QB, he gonna do it for us. Let's go. Let's go. Welcome to Relevant Sports Talk, episode 10. Back at it again. Thank y'all for tuning in. Appreciate all the love. Thank y'all for subscribing. Thanks for spreading the word out. Subscriptions keep going up and up and up, so that's what's up. The word's getting out there. I'm having people hit me up, so big things might be popping off. So let's keep it rolling, keep it rolling. I know we hit a snag a couple days ago, but man, we're going to make it still go. So comments and replies, start us off like we always do. Whole lot of Tua talk when I brought it up, whether we're going to send them or we're going to go. It stayed about 50-50 between everybody. I mean, I understand the fact of trying to lose somebody, you know, after the first game or whatever. But I don't live my life in fear, yo. I'll tell you that right now. And the way the market is, I mean, you could lose a quarterback in one step. You know what I'm saying? I remember a couple years ago, we had Alex Smith. We out here top of the division. We doing it. Then all of a sudden, he had a freak leg. He almost died. You know what I'm saying? I'm not putting him in the same thing as Tua because he's a rookie and all this. But I feel like if he's healthy, you got a rookie deal. So it means you got 5 years to do what you got to do. And he's healthy and cleared. Get on the field, bro. We already know what Ryan Fitzpatrick's going to do for you. You'll be 7-9. He's going to throw up some gaudy numbers, but he's going to give you gaudy interceptions, and you ain't going to really win. You know, let him get used to that line. Let them grow together. I mean, hey, whatever. You know what I'm saying? If it's meant for him to get hurt, it's meant for him to get hurt. That's the way I look at it. You know what I mean? You can't hide the inevitable. If it's going to happen, it's going to happen. That's the way I look at it. I mean, but whatever. We're talking about the running back situation, and I got hit a lot on that, you know what I'm saying? I got banged on that one. Nobody really agreed with me about value in the running backs. What some people said, it was like the last of a dying breed was the ones that I brought up, stuff like that. And possibly, I mean, possibly right, you know what I'm saying? But then every year it seems like it's always the next one. We always talk about, we ain't paying these mugs, we ain't paying these mugs. And all this offseason I saw what? Why ain't Derrick Henry getting his money? Why ain't Derrick Henry getting his money? Well, it's because of the same reason why ain't nobody want to pay, you know, anybody else. You know what I'm saying? We saw the things that happened with Le'Veon Bell holding out. Da 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 da. He ain't the same no more. Whether he want to be a rapper or what he want to be, I don't know what he want to do no more. But he was the most dynamic running back in the league. Now he done slipped and fell. You know what I'm saying? Melvin Gordon, I talked about, tried to hold out for money. You know what I'm saying? Luckily, Denver gave you a 2-year deal, which they ain't have to because I liked the running backs they had. Tell you the truth, I'm not saying Melvin Gordon's not better than them. All I'm saying is they ain't have to, and they could have added somebody else if they needed to that was way cheaper. But whatever. John Elway's going all in on it. Cool. That might be a huge thing for them. Ty Gurley, we talked about that. So we see the repetition of running backs and, you know, the contracts or whatever. Nobody wants to pay nobody. But last year we saw Zeke. He held out. We didn't know what was going to happen. But he got his money. So what's going to happen next year? Is he going to be gone? Is this going to be a continuing trend? And we just saw Christian McCaffrey get the most money. So, or is he the exception to the rule? You know what I mean? I feel like every year we always have an exception to the rule. I feel like we can't keep having exceptions to the rules if we're going to say that breed is over. And then we can't have it both ways. We either got to stop paying the running backs all this daggone money and say that we devalue them. We don't value them the same. Or, you know, whichever way you're going to do. Because I'll tell you what, yeah, Christian McCaffrey on paper right now sounds like, ooh, yeah, we got Christian McCaffrey. Look what he's doing. Da, 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 da. But let him take a wrong hit or let him come up short a few yards. Now we're like, running backs, we can get. It's going to be the same thing with everybody. I'm telling you. You know, it's a shiny quarter right now. It's a shiny piece of metal. Yeah, it looks really pretty now. When that rust starts getting on it, that dirt starts getting on it, you want to get another piece. So, if you're a running back, enjoy it while you can. And that's why people are trying to get these short deals in the beginning. That position is the one position that is hurt by the most by this collective bargaining agreement. Because you sign a five-year rookie deal. Five-year rookie deal for all these other positions, you're like, I'm sorry. For the GMs, you're like, good, I want 5 years to figure out if my quarterback's good enough because it's the most important part of the team, right? But for the running backs, you're like, shit, man. Let me get, like, especially these high picks, let me get, like, a three-year deal. Because after my second, third year, you already know I'm going to be a beast. Let me sign a fat deal then. Now they're like, nah, bro. You a good year two, year three. We still got two more years for you. And if you try to hold out, it ain't look good for nobody else. So, if you're running backs now, yo, I don't even know. It's tough. It's tough. But I'm happy for whoever. I'm happy for whoever gets their money. So we did a lot of QB talk. We've been going back and forth with all those. All right, this is the final thing I'm gonna say about this part right here. All right, if we had the next 10 years, the same amount of money, the best team possible that they can be on, which one of these four would you want? Because I'm hearing a lot of people talk about this and comparing this quarterback, this quarterback, this quarterback. All things are the same. All things are the same. What order would you put these four in? Carson Wentz, Jared Goff, Jameis Winston, Dak Prescott. Where are we going with those? You tell me what order you putting those in. And then I can show you the money that we're talking about. Then I can show you how this money situation is, whatever. Goff is going to be my number four. And I'm sure Goff will probably be other people's number four. So when I talk about Goff with their money, we already know that that contract was the worst contract in a long time in NFL history. Everybody knows that. So when I talk about his contract, I don't talk about nothing. I don't even bring him up. But I look at all the other ones. My number four was Goff. My number three is Dak Prescott. And I know I'm going to get backlash for that. People are going to say he's better than Winston. I'm not going to say that. Remember what I said. The next 10 years, same amount of money, and on the best team possible. And so when I say the best team possible, that's also coaching. You can't tell me that the proper coach and the proper situation around you, that Jameis Winston would definitely not have a better 10-year career than Dak Prescott. I'm sorry. If you believe that, that's a problem. Because Jameis Winston is way more physically gifted than Dak Prescott ever could be. Yeah, Dak could probably run a little bit better. But Jameis Winston's mechanics and arm talent and all that, yeah, boy. I'll take it. And what's he getting per year? And what's Dak want? 40? 38? 40 million? So, my number three was Dak. My number two was Winston. And my number one was Carson Wentz. And so Carson Wentz getting the money he got, I mean, that's what I see when we talk about the market and we say, oh, well, Dak's just in the market. No, Carson Wentz got his money in the market. I agree with that because Carson Wentz can be that guy. With all things the same and all things perfect, I think he could be that guy. I think he brings it all to the table. So, and this is not another Dak Prescott bashing or nothing like that. I get so frustrated when people are like, oh, my God, pay him his money. Pay him his money. Well, they're trying to pay him his money. You think they want to give him a franchise tag or $31 million and they ain't trying to give him his money? They trying to give him his money. He wants more. He wants more money. I mean, that's the problem, man. Come on, bro. I mean, are you worth that much money? Really, dude? I mean, come on, man. I don't know. Breaking news. The Jaguars have got a new quarterback. He is off the QB market. We don't have to worry about it. What? Oh, Jaguars signed Mike Glennon. Mike Glennon is the new quarterback in Jacksonville. So what's that mean for Cam Newton? I'm tired of hearing him talk about the Redskins and Cam Newton. I mean, I ain't gonna lie though, I'll take Cam and get rid of the other backup we got here. I'll take Cam. And I'll have my boy sit for another year. I don't care. I'll take Cam. I ain't scared to say I'll take Cam. On the cheap, on the Jameis Winston shit. You know what I'm saying? But where's he gonna go? I feel like if the Redskins things had a little glimmer, the Chargers might have a 1-year deal glimmer just to have their rookie sit, maybe. I think the Patriots thing has got it's going like this. Stidham starting to be like that. Where's he gonna play? I feel like I don't know. I think it's gonna take somebody to get hurt. And that's horrible to say. But I don't know, man. But they talk about the Redskins, so we'll see. Speaking of the Redskins, let's dive into the NFL schedule that just got released. The schedule. We talked about who had the easiest schedule, the Ravens, and the hardest, Patriots. None of that matters. You want to know why? You know who had the easiest schedule last year? You know what our record was? 3-12. Now, granted, it's part of the team that sucks as opposed to the Ravens or the Patriots, but it don't matter because nobody knows who's going to be doing what by the middle of the year. You never know who's going to be where, what's going on, whatever. But let's dive into this, man. I'm not going to go past week one because, like I said, you never know who's going to be where, what's going on, la, 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 la. But come on, man. One thing about the NFL season is, just like in fantasy, you never know who's going to be good. We all do our fantasy drafts. We all do this who we think's going to be. Or we pick our division winners, or we pick all this because of what we think compared to what happened last year or previous years. So, really the only game that really gets you like this much excited is the first week because it's built up through all the offseason. You're like, ooh, I can't wait to week one. You know, so when I see Monday Night Football and I see Pittsburgh versus the Giants, I'm like, what? That's the game you got on there? Pittsburgh and the Giants? We can't do nothing better than that on week one? Pittsburgh and the Giants. Now, granted, they have two good, strong fan bases. So, if you're a fan of them teams, you're like, yeah, we're going to get a storied franchise. And blah, 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 blah. But if you ain't a fan of them, it's like, oh, all right. What was the second Monday night game? Tennessee versus Denver. Well, I mean, I guess that's okay. Denver's okay. Because Tennessee went to the AFC Championship game. You got Derrick Henry talking about he's supposed to get all his money. Is Ryan Tannehill worth all his money? You know, then you got this Denver team with Lockett QB, all these rookie weapons everywhere, second-year weapons, and Melvin Gordon. I mean, Denver might have the most interesting team on offense that you've seen in a while. But the craziest thing to me about that game is Denver is favored by 2.5 points. Now, granted, they're at home, so they usually give you 3 points. So I guess on a neutral field, Tennessee would have been favored by 0.5, like 0.1, 0.5 points. But Denver's favored. I could have seen Tennessee being favored by 3 on the road. So maybe it's something about Denver, yo. I don't know. But I thought that was interesting to see that Denver was favored. But like I said, that's an okay Monday night game. This interest there is okay. And I'm like, okay, and it's going to be a meat and potatoes game. It's got to be on Sunday Night Football. Sunday Night Football has got to be the meat and potatoes game. I don't know about you guys, but Sunday Night Football seems like it's more popping than Monday Night Football, I'll tell you the truth. As the season be going on, Sunday Night Football just seems like it'd be like, yeah, I'd be getting more hype for that. I don't know if it's because the football was all during the day and then that last game, like, yeah. As opposed to Monday, it's like, comes on, do you gotta go to work? I mean, I don't know what it is, but Sunday night just seems like it's popping off to me as the game compared to Monday night. Anyway, so I'm like, here it comes, meat and potatoes game. Who's it gonna be? Let's go. And Cowboys and Rams. Really? Cowboys and Rams? Really? I mean, I know it's a new stadium for the Rams, but really? Maybe I'm a Cowboy hater. Maybe that's what it is, but I mean, I feel like there's got to be a more intriguing matchup week one than any of those three games put on primetime. Now, the Tennessee-Denver game, I'm fine with it being on one of the Monday night slots, whatever, but wasn't there another game that was supposed to be, hold on, isn't there a team with a brand new quarterback, maybe the best quarterback ever? Tampa Bay, that's right, Tampa Bay. Tampa Bay's playing their first game, right? Yeah, with Tom Brady and Gronk, that's right. And who do they play? Oh, they probably play some scrubs. That's why they're not on prime time. They play the Saints and Drew Brees. Really? Obviously, the two front runners for the division, but two out of the maybe three or four teams that are favored to win the NFC. They're playing week one, and they're not on prime time. Really? Really? Brady versus Brees, week one. Check him out at 4 o'clock. Whatever. I mean, I'm just like, get out of here. But interesting fact about that, Tom Brady's played 74 straight regular season games and been favored. The Saints are favored by 6.5. You know what that says? Bucks win. Just because everything looks like, oh, Tampa Bay hasn't had time to get together. They haven't had time to work out. First time he's ever been favored. La la la, this is Drew Brees' year. He's went through a lot of heartache. La 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 la. Bucks win. Now, to their credit, the next time they play is week 9 in November. It's a Sunday night game. Like I said, them Sunday night games. Sunday night games. New Orleans at Tampa Bay. So, yeah, but you never know. Week 9, somebody could be... You never know what could be going on week 9. I know what's going on week 1. Everybody's healthy and ready. That's why you put it on week 1. Let's go. Because you know it's already there. Okay, whatever. All right. Another game that's... like I said, I'm not going to be diving into all these weeks. But I know week 2, I'm excited for. It's a Monday night game. Las Vegas Raiders first home game. I'm intrigued to see that. I want to see what it looks like. And they are playing the Saints too, so that's cool. But I want to see what they look like. Their uniform, the stadium, the fireworks. You know it's going to be crazy coming off there. The Christmas. We had a Christmas game. Vikings and Saints. Hey, what's the Saints on everything? Saints everywhere. Saints everywhere. Even though that's my Super Bowl pick. Saints. But it's on a Friday night. That's crazy, right? A Friday night? I need to check and see if there's a Thursday night game that week, too. So it'll be Thursday, Friday. They probably don't have a Thursday one, but first time since 2009, Friday night game. Friday night lights, NFL style. That's going to be pretty cool. And Thanksgiving. Who cares who Detroit plays? I mean, it didn't even matter. Detroit's like the Bobcats with Jordan. Nobody cares. You're not doing anything to be relevant. You're always still the same. But I'll tell you what. The other two games need to be on Thanksgiving every year. Every year, these four teams should play. The second game, Cowboys game, should be Redskins-Cowboys. Every year, Redskins-Cowboys Thanksgiving. Cowboys and Indians on Thanksgiving. Every year. It needs to be every year. It needs to be tradition like that. That's how the rivalry... I mean, the rivalry's still good, but you keep the rivalry at the peak by doing it that way. I mean, with the Redskins sucking for so long and the Cowboys being mediocre for so long, their rivalry start... I mean, it's still high, but it ain't like it used to be because you see Cowboys and Eagles hate each other because the Eagles are the leading division, you know, and the Redskins and Giants because we both suck all the time. You know, Cowboys and Redskins need to be on Thanksgiving every year. One thing, it'll get their rivalry back up here. But it's just, it fits. It fits. It needs to be there. The third game needs to always be Ravens Steelers. I don't care where they play at. They can alternate where they play. I could care less. But Ravens Steelers is blood and sweat, tears in that game. I love watching it. I used to love watching. I love still to this day watching. So they definitely need to be on there every week. That being said, I know I messed with the whole schedule and all that. The way the NFL did things, which is very smart. They got a flexibility with the Super Bowl for months. So any week possible, 1 through 16, 1 through 17, can be week 1. So let's say that season can't start theoretically until week 4 or something. Week 4 would be week 1. 1, 2, and 3 would go to the back end. That's how dope they got their flexibility. I thought that was pretty sweet. So here I am talking about, week 1 ain't got enough this in it. That might wind up being the last week of the season. So it could work out. It could work out. They might know some things I don't know. But anyway, it's so good to talk about matchups in football because I can't wait. Can't wait. Last thing I'll talk about for a quick second, since I don't know much about it, but I've been watching the previews and the highlights and all this stuff. It got me pumped to see what's going to happen. I'm going to try to bootleg this somewhere off YouTube or somewhere because I ain't paying $40 for it or whatever, $50. But that UFC tonight, Ferguson versus Gaethje, yo, I want to see that joint. And plus there's some other shit on the card. It's like another title fight, some other people on there. But yo, y'all see who else is on there? The original woman beater, Craig Hardy. I'm not making fun of him beating up women, but I'm like, this dude still got a job, really? Craig Hardy still rocking? Do people care? He probably gets booed every time he walks up in that octagon. But yeah. But hey, remember this date, guys. Remember this date, May 23rd at 8 p.m., I'm actually going to be on the Rich Myers podcast show, which is also going to be on Spotify, his Spotify Google public radio station, and on Breaker. He's going to be doing a live interview with me about the Relism Sports Talk Show, different things like that. So I appreciate the love, Rich Myers. Thank you. I'm pumped for the whole interview and everything. And guys, listen to the Rich Myers show, May 23rd, 8 p.m., make sure y'all remember. I'm gonna bring it up every day on the show because I'm so excited about it. That's so hype. I'm so hyped, man, to get the word out. Relevance of Sports Talk. Everybody, remember, keep spreading the word. Spread the word, Rich Myers. Let's go. We all work together. We can make this thing pop. Appreciate y'all's support, guys. Y'all have a good one. Enjoy the weekend and enjoy the last dance. Episode 7 and 8. It's almost to the end, but I can't wait to see the next two. All right, y'all.